Hello friends, today I am going to explain about the expression for efficiency of Otto cycle. So for this, we need to draw PV and PS diagram. So this is pressure and this is volume. So volume we will calculate, the unit for volume is meter cube and pressure will be taken as bar. So, for this Otto cycle, if you draw, 1 to 2 process is adiabatic compression and 2 to 3 process is heat addition, 3 to 4 process is heat in expansion process, adiabatic expansion, and 4 to 1 is heat release. So, what we do is for 1 to 2 is adiabatic process, PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant, and this is heat addition process, which is constant volume V is equal to C, and this is again PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant, which is adiabatic expansion, and this is heat release, which is again constant volume process. If I draw the temperature and improve the diagram for this, so this is temperature and this is entropy. If I draw diagram, so 1 to 2 will be adiabatic compression and 2 to 3 is constant volume and so 3 to 4 is adiabatic expansion and 4 to 1 is again constant volume. So I write here 2 to 3 is constant volume and 4 to 1 is constant volume process. Okay. So 1 to 2, 4 and 4. So here 1 to 2 is adiabatic and 2 to 3 is a heat addition, heat supply and heat rejection. Again here heat supply, here heat rejection. So now we are going to see in detail from process wise. So first let us take process 2 to 3. So heat supply is equal to Qs is equal to UCV P3 minus P2, which is M is equal to mass in kg, as you can see, specific heat and constant volume, P3 temperature minus T2 temperature. So this is one equation, and the next equation is heat rejection, which is QR is equal to MCV T4, this is curve 4, this is T4 minus T1. So this is the expression for heat supply and this is the expression for heat rejector. Now we will see the process wise, process 1 to 2. Process number 2, which is adiabatic process. So T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 whole to the power of gamma minus 1. So in this we can find out temperature T2 is equal to T1 into V1 by V2 whole to the power of gamma minus 1, where V1 by V2 is equal to compression ratio RC. So in this, we can write this as T2 is equal to T1 into compression ratio over to the power of gamma minus 1. So this is how we are going to find out the T2 temperature. So T1 will be given in the problem and P1 will be given, and so we need to find out P1, V1 and T1. Next P2, V2, T2, P3, V3, T3, P4, V4, T4. So we need to find out all the pressure, temperature, volume in all these salient points. So now we have to found out T2. So again, so how to find out V2? So T1, V1 whole to the power of gamma is equal to T2, V2 whole to the power of gamma. In this, V1 by V2 whole to the power of gamma is equal to T2 by V1. So V1 by V2 whole to the power of gamma is equal to V2 by So in this, if we know P1, so we can find out P2, otherwise we can find any of these volumes in this equation. So this is all about process 1 to 2. And process 2 to 3, next, process 2 to 3, which is heat addition process. Already we have done QS is equal to MCV T3 minus T2. So T1, P2, V2 by T2 is equal to T3, V3 by T3. So as I told you, the volume is constant, V2 is equal to V3. So V2 is equal to V3, both gets cancelled. So finally, V2 by T2 is equal to V3 by T3. So in this we can find out T3 is equal to P2 into T3 by T2. So in this we can find out T3. So next if we go to the process 3 to 4. So process 3 to 4, which is again adiabatic expansion. So we can write T3 by T4 is equal to V4 by V3 over the power of gamma minus 1. This can be written as V4 is equal to V1. Alright? So V4 in the place of V4 we can write V1, and V3 in the place of V3 we can write V2. So over the power of gamma minus 1. So this V1 by V2 is nothing but compression ratio RC over the power of gamma minus 1. So next, so T3 is equal to V4 into RC to the power of gamma minus 1. So in this 3 to 4 process, we can find out T3 or T4. So once you find all the temperatures, P1, V1, V1, T2, 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 T3, V3, T3, P4, V4, T4, then efficiency of auto cycle is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by RC to the power of gamma minus 1. So this is the efficiency for auto cycle. So 1 minus 1 divided by RC means V1 by V2 is equal to RC. We put this value, over to the power of gamma is equal to 1.4 for 8.